Everyone loves an underdog. But we've seen 1-2-3 Kids stunning Razor Ramon and the Hurricane beating The Rock a few million times now. Here are six upsets that are forgotten by everyone except the guy who won and probably the guy who lost. 2 weeks before facing Brock Lesnar in an Extreme Rules match, John Cena had a warm-up against the monstrous Tensai. Despite Tensai's imposing size, Cena seemingly had the match won with the STF locked in. But John Laurinaitis sent David Otunga in to ruin Cena's night. The distraction allowed Tensai to spit green mist in Cena's face and lay him out for the win. Dean Ambrose handed Seth Rollins one of his most surprising losses, and he wasn't even in the match. During Rollins' August 2014 bout against Heath Slater on Raw, the Lunatic Fringe dumped a drink in Rollins' Money in the Bank briefcase, then topped it off with popcorn and JBL's hat.
Oh no, look at your hat, look at your hat! Come on, somebody call the police!
While Rollins screamed for him to stop, Slater rolled Rollins up for a stunning victory. Vladimir Kozlov was on a serious tear in February 2009. He capped the month off by becoming one of the select superstars to defeat The Undertaker. So when the Dead Man set up for his iconic old-school move, the Moscow Mauler pulled him into a decisive power slam.
My God, I can't believe it! Shocking!
Randy Orton defeated Carlito by illegally grabbing the tights during a pinfall. But a tribute to the troops that year, Orton got a taste of his own medicine in the rematch. Randy attempted to steal another win by putting his feet on the ropes, but the referee caught him this time. And while Orton argued with the official, Carlito rolled him up, grabbing the trunks for extra leverage and shocking the Viper. Just in time for the 1999 holiday season, the McMahon-Helmsley regime was in the giving spirit. Al Snow demanded a match with The Rock, and they delivered in the form of a Brahma bull rope match. When Road Dogg's chair shot couldn't keep Rock down, Billy Gunn rushed in for a Famouser, allowing Snow to climb over the Great One for the win. The May 9th, 2002 episode of SmackDown marked the arrival of Batista.
Who is that?
It's a very big, mean-looking dude.
The combination of the Deacon and Chris Jericho allowed Reverend D-Von to upset Triple H.
That steel box was supposed to be for God's work. Tonight it was for Jericho's damn dirty work.
When it comes to WWE, any superstar can win on any night. Until next time, thanks for watching.